Hello friend, welcome back. In this video, I will start a new session. It's about set up form view for project template. Because I told you, I will create one of the complete project. And every dynamic project, they have the two part. One is the front-end part and another is the back-end part. So in this session, I will work in our front-end and laterally, I will work for the back-end. For doing this, now go to your exercise file. And into the exercise file here, I created one of the folder as a project template. And now if you open it, now that is actually the one of the zip files. So first of all, you have to extract that file. Then you will get this type of folder as a template. And then into the template area, you can see there have the two type of folder. One is the front-end folder and another is the back-end. So first of all, I want to work in our front-end. So if you now open that folder like here, there is index.html, there is a single.html, and then there is a category.html. So if you now open that page like here, I just open it. So our course will be look like this. After end of this course, we will create one of the complete online news portal. So here you can see there is all that header part, and here some of the menu, there is a sub menu, there is the logging and the registration button, and here all that lead news, and also there is all that categories news, there is a mobile category, there is a tablet PC category, okay, and also there is a gazette. On a lot of the category, one by one, all that news will be posted on particular disposition, and also there is the footer part. So that is the footer part. So we'll create one of the complete online news portal. Okay, so that will be our design. So that is our index design. And if you go to the category page, so there is another page as a category.html, and this category page will be just look like this. Okay, so here that is actually the mobile category, and here there all the popular news will be visible on particular disposition. And also there is all that related category post will be visible on here, and also there have the pagination, okay, and there is also the news subscription system. So it's pretty much interactive. And if you go to the single page like here, if you click on here, now you see that is redirected to the single.html. So for all that file, now actually a static file, so that is our single page. So this single page will be look like this. So there is also there is option for the comment option. Okay, so user can add some of the comment from to this area, and also there is the most commented will be visible on here. So this type of things I want to create. So they have the three pages for the reasons I told you. They have the three pages is one of the is the index. So we have to actually make the things dynamic step by step. I will show you there is a category and there is a single page. So right now, first of all, I want to work for our index page. That means I just want to make that dynamic. Okay, that means this index.html page. So for doing this, first of all, we have to go to our asset, and into the asset folder, like they have some of the elements like JS file, there is the images, all that images, there is the fonts, and there is the CSS. So that's all that CSS file. As I told you, now right now there is actually one of the static site. Okay, on particular disposition, all that CSS will be needed. There is the images. So all that images actually comes from here. And now there is also the JS file. So first of all, we have to copy all the things. Now I want to include that template in our project. So now go to our project area. So that is our project area. And into this position, like there is a public. And into the public here, I want to actually create one of the folder for our font. So here I just create one of the folder as a font. Okay, I just create all one of the folder. And into the folder here, I paste all that our data, that means asset data. So here I just added all that our CSS, fonts, images, and JSS, which I actually get that things from our template area. In our template, there is an asset. So right now I just first of all copy all the things and paste in our this page. That means in our public, and I just created one of the folder as a font, and here I paste it. Hope you can well understand about it. Now we have to go to our template area. So here there is our template. Now I just want to work in our index.html. So now I just open it with the sublink text editor, and here there is the index.html. So first of all, here I want to do, I just copy all the things from here, and I already created one of the page in particular disposition as a news and about, and here I load our master. Okay, I already discussed about that things with you. If you go to the view page, so there is actually the master blade. So now I remove all the things from to this position, and here I paste it. Okay, that means our static, all that index data, I paste it in our masterblade.php page. And now if you save that page, like here I save it, and now I want to access that masterblade. So here there is our about. So if you now click on the enter, then it should be look like with a different way. And here you can see he only get the text because of actually this should be look like this one, but it's now look like that way because of here I didn't add our CSS, all the JSS file and also the images. Okay, because here I just added only static data. Here you can see there is the asset, JS and the jQuery. So that was actually the file location. So right now I just included that things in our Laravel project. So for the reasons we have to do, we have to update that all link for the JS link. We have to update it. And also there is the images. Okay. So here we also have to update the images link, like there is the asset, image and logo. So that is actually the path we have to update. And also our this CSS class, we also have to update it. So how can do that work? For doing this, first of all, here you have to do it's pretty much easy process. First of all, you have to define one of the second bracket. So they have the two second bracket, and into the second bracket they have one of the function as a asset in Laravel. Okay, so here I just define that asset, and asset means actually the root. Okay, like here if you go to these positions, like there is our pro and there is a news, that means that is actually the, our root. So asset, this function means the root. So after the root, where exactly our file, like there is the images and then the our favicon.png. So there's a file actually located in our, if you go to this position, then in our font, in our font folder there is the images, and into the particular folder this images is remaining. Okay, I hope you can well understand about it. So asset means that this root, and after we have to add the public and then the font and then the images and then the images name. Okay, so I just want to do that work. Like here there is an asset, and after that asset here I have to define it, like I have to define the public, and then I have to go to the font, and then I have to go to the our images. Okay, like here if you go to these positions, like public, font and the images, and then the images name. So here I just defining our images name, like then there is the images folder, and then there is actually the png. Okay, so right now I just paste that things on here. So here I update our path, and now it should be work. Okay, and also we have to do the same things for our this CSS class. So if you go to this position, first of all here you have to define the two double second bracket, and then you have to define the root. So here I added the root as an asset. Okay, asset means the root, and after that asset here you have to declare the path. So after that asset, so now I want to actually access this bootstrap min.css. So where exactly the file location? So first of all, that is actually our root, and this root I just assign that with this asset. Okay, and then we have to go to the public folder, and then the font folder, and then the CSS, and here you can see that is actually the bootstrap min.css. So now we have to assign that particular location, that is a public, font and the CSS. So now I want to do that work on particular this area. First of all, there is a public and then the font, and then I have to define the CSS, and then I have to define this path name, that means this file name, CSS file name. So here I assign that CSS file name. Okay, I hope you can well understand about it. So that's how we have to update our all the CSS, like that is actually better. I just copy it. Okay, I just copy it, and I just open one of the page on particular dispositions like this one. Okay, so for now I just copy it, and now here there is another, there is an asset, font, and there is a font awesome. There is actually another class, like here if you go to this position, like in our font, so they have the another folder as a font, and they have another as a font awesome. So here we have to define it. Okay, so that is actually will be our path, and then we have to define that CSS. So here I want to do like better I just copy it. Okay, I just copy and that things from here, and here I just paste it. So after that font we have to go where, we have to go that font, then we have to go the fonts, and then the font awesome, right? So here we have to define it. So after that font, here already they have the fonts and the font awesome folder, and then the CSS. For now I just copy it, and here I just paste that in some particular disposition. So right now we don't need this, I just remove it. So I hope you can well understand about it. So there is a public, and there is a public, after that public there is a, one of the folder I created as a font, and after that they have another folder as a fonts, and then the font awesome and then the font CSS. So that's how you have to actually update for every CSS, and also you have to update the images. Like there is actually the logo. Okay, like here if you want to add that, like I just do it, I just copy it and here I just paste it. So for now, for the images after the font, they have the another folder. Like here, if you go to this position, like there after that font folder, there are the image. That means this image. So here I have to define it. So after that font here, I just define the image. So here I already have. So I just copy it. And after the font here, I just define that image's name. Then we don't need this. I just remove that things from here. Okay, so that's how we also have to update our all that images on particular disposition. I think it's very much clear to you how the things you have to update. So that is actually all that file images, and also that is a JS file. So you also have to update the JSS file. So in the JSS file, there have if you go to this position, there is a public, and then you have to go to the font, and in the font there is a JS file. Okay. Into the JS folder, that is actually the file you have to assign. So it's pretty much same things, but I just copy it, and here I just want to do one. Okay, then it should be easy for you. Like you have to go the public and then the font, and then you have to go where you have to go to the JS folder, right? So after the JS, then there's actually our file. So here already JS is here, so I just copy it, and after that font, so I just assign that things on here. Okay, it's pretty much easy. I hope you can well understand about it. So now that your task, so one by one you have to update all the JS file link, you have to update the images link. Okay, so you have to also update the images, so all the images you have to update it. So I will do that work, and when I will update that file, then I will come back again. So here I updated all that link for the JSS, here I updated all that images. Okay, so here you can see I updated all that images, and all that images I updated on particular disposition, and also I updated the CSS on particular this area. So now if you click on the save all, now I just click on the save all. Before that was actually without CSS, JSS and images, it used to look like this. So now I want to access the about again, and now I just click on the refresh. Yes, you can see now it's perfectly visible on here, because he get all the CSS, he get all the JSS, he get all the images, and now it's perfectly just look like our template. So now it's perfectly look on here. So I hope you can well understand about it. So now that is actually the static, so that's totally static data is now visible on here. So we have to make the things dynamic. I already discussed about that things with you, how can create the section, how can create the yield. Okay, so now we have to apply the same things in our this master blade. So then I just want to make the things dynamic. Okay, so how can do that work in our next video? I will show you that things with the live example. So thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.